Now let us see how we can actually create a virtual machine with custom configuration. So here I am using my Mac, and as I already have a virtual box with Vagrant, I am creating a directory called CentOS 7 and getting into that directory. And if I run Vagrant in it, it will create a Vagrant file for us in that directory. You can see here. And if you look at the Vagrant file, most of the lines of code are actually commented out, except this one where we say vagrant.configure of to do config, which means we are trying to use the second version of Vagrant, and then config VM box. The words base came because we haven't passed anything to our Vagrant in it. When we actually try to bring this box up, it will actually search for base in this location. If it could not find, it will fail. And then only other line which is not commented out is the end. So the three lines of code is not commented out. Rest of the stuff is commented out to actually give an idea about the parameters which we can leverage to customize the creation of Vagrant boxes. The script is a Ruby script, but you don't need to break your head to understand Ruby from scratch and work on this. If you actually try to interpret this closely from the perspective of creating and managing virtual machines, then it is pretty straightforward. And I will try to cover those things as part of this series. That being said, if I say Vagrant up, because there is no base in the Vagrant cloud, it will fail. Either you can remove this Vagrant file like this, and then init by saying CentOS 7. CentOS 7 is a valid box in the Vagrant cloud. If you bring it up by running Vagrant up, it will actually download the CentOS 7 image. And using VirtualBox as provider, it will actually bring up the virtual machine for us. Whereas on our Linux server, we have set up Vagrant on top of KVM and libvirt. It will be using those components to create the virtual machines. But on our PC, we have installed VirtualBox and then Vagrant, and we are trying to use VirtualBox to start these virtual machines. Once the virtual machine is created, you can actually run Vagrant SSH and you will be able to connect into that virtual machine. Okay, now you are in the virtual machine which is created by Vagrant. You can run LSCPU and see how many CPUs it is using. It is using one CPU by default, and you can run free-h. It is using 512 MB as memory for this virtual machine by default. And you can run df-h and it is using 38 dB storage. Now, if you want to customize this, you can open this Vagrant file. Okay. And you can actually go through these lines of code. If you want to give static IP, there is one thing where you can uncomment and it will try to assign a static IP. And if you scroll down further, based upon the provider, whether it is VirtualBox or libvirt, you can actually customize the configuration of your virtual machine. For example, in this case, if I want to start the virtual machine with 2 GB memory, I have to uncomment this and also uncomment this and uncomment this. Now we are trying to create a virtual machine with 2 GB, we have to replace this with 2048, and this is 2048 MB. And then you can also say vb.cpus equal to 2. Instead of using one CPU, it will be using two CPUs. To get more details, you just have to go to browser and search for Vagrant VirtualBox and hit enter. Then you can go to the help here. This one is actually covering how to set up VirtualBox and Vagrant on top of it. More importantly, you should go to configuration and you can see what all different options you have. Okay. If you are using VirtualBox, if you want to get the GUI up and running whenever you start the virtual machine, when I say GUI, the VirtualBox GUI, which we have seen when we actually set up to create a virtual host. You can give the name to the virtual machine. So let's try giving a name also. So in this case, the way you can give the name is by saying vb.name equal to centos7.itvarsity.com. Okay. And there are few more things which you can leverage. At times, you might have to add more storage, not only memory and CPU. For that, you need to have additional plugins. As we'll be primarily using libvirt, we will explore how we can actually define those properties from libvirt perspective. But depending upon the provider, you need to understand that some of the settings might change. That being said, now I'm saving this. And we can say Vagrant reload. It will shut down the running virtual machine and it will relaunch the virtual machine with the new upgraded settings with respect to memory and CPU. Now it is started. You can actually say Vagrant SSH and then run LSCPU. You can see it is using two CPUs now, not one CPU. And also you can say free-h. And it is using 2 GB memory, not 1 GB, or 512 MB, which we have seen earlier, and so on and so forth. This is how you can actually customize. You can also run hostname minus F. Okay. I think name is only to reflect here. So if you run Vagrant status, okay, it is still saying default. Let me see. I have defined the name also. I don't know why it is not using this name. I need to check. Anyway, as we are not going to use VirtualBox that much on the PC, I'm not troubleshooting this issue. But I hope you get an idea about how we can actually even customize on our PC. That being said, now I am connecting to rnd.itvarsity.com where we have a 64 GB server. And we'll start with one virtual machine the same way as we have started on our Mac or PC. And then we'll actually see how we can create multiple virtual machines in one shot. Again, I am creating a directory here, CentOS 7, and getting into that directory. And then I am running sudo vagrant init CentOS/7. It will create a Vagrant file. I am opening that Vagrant file and I am removing all these commented lines. Okay, the reason why it is opened in read-only is because I have created this Vagrant file with sudo permissions. So let me remove this and let me say Vagrant init CentOS 7. You should be able to create Vagrant file as a non-root user without sudo, but you will not be able to bring it up if you are using libvirt. Okay, you can actually try it out, Vagrant up, and it might not work. You can see it is failing, but if I say sudo, it will work. It will download the CentOS 7 box and it will create the virtual machine for you. Now, as the virtual machine is created, you can again run Vagrant SSH. All these commands have to be run using sudo because the machine is brought up as sudo. And you can actually run LSCPU command. There is only one CPU here. You can run df-h. By default, it have assigned 38 GB storage. You can run free-h where the virtual machine is using 512 MB RAM. Now you can exit and go to Vagrant file and remove all these commented lines. We will remove this also. Let me remove all these things except this one, because we want to customize our virtual machine with respect to memory, CPU and storage. So I'm uncommenting this. And I don't want this, I don't want this. I don't want this. I don't want this comment. Now I'm uncommenting this. I'm uncommenting this and I'm deleting all these things. Okay, and this is a very simple Ruby code. What it is doing, it is actually using Vagrant 2 configuration, and it is looping and actually setting the properties, and then it is actually creating the virtual machine using that configuration. So wherever you need to be provider specific, again you have to create a simple loop like this for depending upon the provider you are using. You have to set the provider specific properties here, and we have to replace this with libvirt because we are using libvirt as provider. Okay, and I want to use LVM, which stands for libvirt virtual machine. With respect to memory, the property is same, and we can define 2 GB like this. With respect to CPUs also, the property is same. And if you want to use any other provider specific properties, again you have to search for Vagrant libvirt documentation. Okay, you can go to this official GitHub page, and if you scroll down, it has so many features and it is very good, and you can actually create the virtual machines and all those things in parallel. Okay, so you can leverage this to actually create virtual machines with a lot of customizations. You can go through this documentation and try to understand the properties as much as you can. Okay, and you can see here how you actually can specify CPUs. You can also define CPU topology, and there are many other things. You just have to spend time and understand these things over a period of time as and when it is required. So when it comes to storage, you can see if the provider is libvirt, there is a property called storage, and you can actually define additional virtual hard drives. So in some cases you might have to create virtual machines simulating as if it have multiple mount points or storage disks, and this is how you can actually simulate. So we can actually copy these two lines, and I will not be creating as raw. I will remove that raw portion. Okay, and then you can save it. But before running it, we have to change this to LVM because we have given the alias as LVM here. Okay, so we are actually getting the libvirt instance by variable LVM. That's why we have to use that. Okay, and on top of these things, you can also set the virtual machine name. It works with any provider. It need not be libvirt itself. It can be any provider. The way you can specify it is like this: config, which is nothing but this one, which is nothing but Vagrant 2 configuration object, VM hostname equal to, let's say, centos7.itversity.com. Okay, you can also define a static IP. By default, there will be only one IP, and that IP might be recycled whenever we restart or reload the machine. To make sure we have a static IP so that we can actually deploy applications and access those things, you can actually use this property called config.vm.network, and this is a universal property. You can have private network. So this is host only network. So from host, you can actually connect to a virtual machine by using a static IP, and you can specify the IP address like this: 192.168.33.10, or you can assign any value as long as this subnet works on the machine. Okay, now you can save it and come out of it this, and then you can actually say sudo vagrant reload. Now the virtual machine will be shut down and restarted with new settings. Now the server is restarted, our virtual machine is restarted. We can say sudo vagrant ssh. Okay. And then you can actually say lscpu. There are two CPUs, free-h, 2 GB memory. And df-h will still show you only 38 GB because we just mounted as raw devices. We have to format those things. You can actually go to cd/dev and then run ls-ltr command. And I think it will be something starting with vd. There should be okay. I know why. So whenever you actually configure hard drive, you have to destroy and restart. Okay. So I am going back to CentOS 7. Oh, I'm in the virtual machine, that's why it is not working. So now what I have to do is I have to say sudo vagrant destroy. We can use -- force to not to get prompted, and then we can say sudo vagrant up. Now you will actually see the additional hard drives mounted. Okay. And also, when we actually try this out without storage on my PC, we have seen that the name of the machine is not started even though we set a property called name while creating the virtual machine. Now, the reason is we just reloaded. We haven't destroyed and recreated. Now, here also we set a property to set the host name. And if you actually connect now, you see the hostname as centos7.itversity.com. You can say lscpu free-h and then dev vd star. You not only have the formatted logical volumes for VDA, you also have VDB and VDC. So VDB and VDC are nothing but the 20 GB and 40 GB additional storage which you have allocated. You can also run hostname-f to get the fully qualified hostname. This is set because of the property config vm hostname. Okay. And also you can run ipaddr to see the IP addresses. We have this static IP on top of the dynamic IP. So the static IP will not change even though we stop this and start it after a long time. You will always have this IP allocated to this virtual machine. This is how you can actually create virtual machines with custom configuration. Now we will actually see how we can create multiple virtual machines by improvising on this Ruby based Vagrant file. Okay.